In the previous movie, we built a flow graph to make servo jump. In this movie, we'll integrate servo's jumping and falling animation clips to make its movement more believable. Open the level Servo Jumping in your current project. You can also copy the content and script folders from the files provided with this movie into a new Stingray project. In the Asset Browser, navigate to the Servo folder and open Servo Anim Controller. Dock the Animation Controller Editor next to the Level Flow tab. This state machine contains a servo idle state and a servo moving blend space state, which mixes servo's walk and run clips together. Each state transitions to the other once Stingray triggers the corresponding animation event. Use the animation preview controls to validate these events and transitions. In the Asset Browser, go to the Animations folder. We've included 3 extra clips for servo's jumping and falling motions. Drag each of these clips into the node graph. Stingray converts them into animation states. To trigger these states, add 3 new anim events. Rename them toFall, toJump, and toRunJump. Next, drag a transition arrow from the idle state to the fall state. Set the transitions on property to toFall. Create another transition in the opposite direction. Assign it the toIdle anim event. Now link the idle state to the jump state and the jump state to the fall state. Repeat this process to connect the moving, run jump, and fall states together. Once you're done, your node graph should look like this. To streamline the node graph, select the jump and fall states, then right-click them and choose Create Group State from Selection. Rename the new group Jumping. Notice that our transitions are updated to reflect the new group. Double-click the jumping state. These 3 states are currently looping. We want to leave this as is for the fall state since servo can fall from varying heights. Conversely, the jump and run jump animations are meant to play only once per jump, so turn their loop property off. This enables the emit and anim event property. Set it to toFall for both states so they automatically transition to the fall state afterwards. Save the animation controller, then validate your changes using the animation preview controls. When you're done, open Servo's unit flow. On each frame, Stingray evaluates the isInputInUse Boolean variable and triggers either the toMove or toIdle anim events. However, this flow graph doesn't take into account whether servo's jumping or falling, so we need to update it in order to trigger our new animation events. We can achieve this using the flow graphs from the Move Character flow. Open it from the Asset Browser. This flow graph controls servo's jump offset by evaluating the following isGrounded and isJumpPressed Boolean variables. While this works great for single update programmatic jumps, we need to adapt it to our new jump animations, which require continuous jump updates. First, disconnect the following nodes for now. Remove them from their group. Next, create a flow graph comprised of a branch node, a not equal node, and a set of get bool variable and set bool variable nodes. Rename the boolean variable nodes to isJumping. We'll use it later in servos unit flow. We want this variable to start out as false, so connect a setBool variable node to the once node to initialize it. Set the not equal node's bport to true to validate the branch node's condition, and set the resulting node's value to true. Connect the branch node to the original flow graph so that triggering a jump sets the isJumping variable to true. Now build another flow graph to trigger the following nodes based on the isJumping boolean variable. Group these nodes together as check for jumping state. Save your changes and test the level. Pressing the jump button causes servo to jump continuously. This is expected since isJumping is currently set to true. We'll address this in a moment. We can now use isJumping and isGrounded to trigger the jump and fall animation events in servo's unit flow. To access a variable between the unit flow and an external flow, turn it into a global variable by setting its node scope port to global. Make sure you set all matching nodes accordingly. Save your changes and go back to servo's unit flow. Update the flow graph so Stingray evaluates isJumping first and isGrounded second. Next, we want to set isJumping to false at the end of servo's jump animations in order to trigger the falling animation. For this, go back to the Animation Controller Editor. Select the servo jump state, then right-click its timeline and choose Add Flow Event, New Flow Event. This event represents a bridge between the animation controller and the unit flow. Rename it Jump End Event. Drag its marker to trigger the event at the end of the animation. Now add the same event to the servo run jump state. Save your changes and go back to servo's unit flow. Create a on animation controller flow events node. Load your current animation controller. Connect the node's jump end event port to the isJumping boolean variable. Save your changes and test the level. We're now successfully triggering servo's jump animations. However, we're still using a programmatic jump speed value instead of extracting it from the root motion. Close the unit flow, then open the character speed flow from the asset browser. In this flow graph, we set the move speed variable based on the root motion's delta position vector. Duplicate the node and rename it jump speed. Connect it to the vector components node's Z port. Don't forget to expose the jump speed as an external output numeric node. When you're done, save your changes and reopen servo's unit flow. All that remains is to transfer servo's jump speed from the character speed node to the move character node. Save your changes and test the level. Servo's jump speed is now derived from its jump animations. However, notice that you can't move Servo forward while he's falling, as if the left thumbstick was unresponsive. This is happening because, contrary to the jump animations, the fall animation doesn't contain root motion. Therefore, the move speed variable returns 0, resulting in a lack of forward momentum. To fix this, we can connect a Boolean variable to the useRootMotionIn port. And then set this variable to true or false based on the animation event we're triggering. With the techniques you learned in this series, you can expand your character's moveset and leap to the next platform.